Greetings YouTube, it's the Brain Damage Gamer here, and we have another episode of Return or Retain. Today I'll be playing Adrift, or Adr1ft. I don't know what the one is supposed to be for, but it's Adrift. I don't know if they're playing on more games in this series or what. But in this episode of Return or Retain, we are going to be playing this game for up to a half hour. I'll be looking for shovelware points, anything that would indicate to me that this game is shovelware, something not worth playing or continuing on. I have seen a little bit about this game in the past. I kind of heard about it indirectly, but haven't actually played it. It does not have a ton of reviews on Steam right now, so we are going to be taking a look and seeing what the quality of the game is and if it genuinely has earned the reviews that it has. Let's go ahead and get going. I was going to click on EVA training, EVA training, but I'm doing a new game. So we're going to go ahead and try to just get it started, see what it does.
Part of an aerospace EVA training simulation, online.
It puts me in the training simulation.
Instructor, Hand 4 Administra, Series 4, version 1.6.
In California.
Trainee, Commander, Oshima, Alex. Mission, Part of an aerospace North Star 4. Mission active date, 29, September, 2035.
Am I up? Oh, I am. Oh, slow movement, okay.
To invert EVA control system, access options menu.
I'm good where it's at. A little bit floaty, but it is in space. So, what a weird bubble I'm in. How did I get into this bubble? Is there a door behind me? Okay. No.
Activate EVA propulsion thrust.
Velocity direction, I'm assuming. Yeah, just a little bump and off I go. So I think this is what a lot of people are looking for with Elite.
Activate EVA propulsion boost.
Alright, so boost. Oh, I pushed it. Okay.
Perform EVA ascend.
Ow. Hit my head. Left click ascend, right click descend. Okay. Standardized stuff. So how do I pick up stuff?
Activate EVA propulsion brake.
Ah, it'll lock me in place. Okay. I want to pick up this particular plant thingy.
Perform EVA roll.
So far, it's interesting. Well, that just swipes. Roll left, roll right. All right.
Activate EVA stabilize.
Oh, reset back to center. Okay.
Oxygen levels are monitored via EVA HUD oxygen meter.
I just slap shit out of my way? Whoa. I don't know what that did that I didn't like.
Objectives are displayed via EVA HUD radar.
Oh, I did that. Alright, G. Did something.
Activate EVA environment scan.
I just did that. Or two. Okay.
Hardiman Aerospace EVA training simulation. Complete.
Hooray!
Exit training module via access portal.
Alright, so what's this? Hang on, what's this crap? So hold F. Okay, so if you tap F, you make with a slapping. But if I hold F. Alright, these are oxygen. Alright. I'm probably gonna be looking for these damn things everywhere from where I've heard of this game. I don't see anything initially that makes me, you know, think low quality or poor translation or anything, you know, the obvious ones I usually get. Alright, where's the exit? Ow. The hell is that thing? Looks like the bottom half of that ball droid from Star Wars. Is it just a soccer ball? I think it is. You see, look, we're back to slapping. Yeah. So, can I open that? I'm trying to get as much of this little random crap out of the way before I actually do anything. No, it's already open. Okay. And I'll just slap at it. Slap you! Wait a minute, this has... Okay, it does have mass. I was gonna say, if I clip through it... Clipping seems to be, like, the very first point I seem to hand out almost every damn time. It's kind of sad, really. Hey, what's that? It's a solid-state drive. Gimme. Aha! I got you! What do I do with it? Did I do something? It's not telling me. That's no good. It's no good if it doesn't tell me what it does. What are you?
Hardiman Corporation was founded by entrepreneur and philanthropist David Hardiman at the age of 27 in 2001.
Okay.
Based in Santa Monica, California, Hardiman Corporation is an entirely charitable organization that exists solely to advance, protect, and preserve the human race. As a young man, Hardiman made billions from various financial ventures, but ultimately found the pursuit of personal wealth hollow and meaningless. Searching for positive and humanitarian ways to funnel his wealth into the lives of those less fortunate, Hardiman began building clean water wells, food sourcing, housing, infrastructure, and education facilities in impoverished third world countries.
Okay.
The seemingly endless need for help opened Hardiman's eyes to the declining state of planet Earth and the greater needs of humanity as a whole. Hardiman dedicated his complete focus, energy, and empire towards solving and eradicating these worldwide threats. With the undeniable
looking for the exit
warming, overpopulation, and the depletion
that
of
one?
Earth's precious natural resources, the need to investigate and identify new inhabitable planets is critical to the future and survival of the human race. Hardiman Aerospace,
where's my exit?
The world's largest privately funded space effort is an ambitious extension of Hardiman Corporation that operates with the sole mission
of
preserving
any exit?
The human race through space exploration.
Like, will this one do?
Taking cues from Hardiman's early efforts providing basic human survival needs, Hardiman Aerospace began the North Star program in 2004. The program's purpose is to create a solution for a natural, sustainable, and renewable source of oxygen that can be managed off-world or on planets without a breathable atmosphere. The North Star
program, cool idea.
Now in its fourth iteration, is an entirely experimental effort.
Oh, wait a minute. The green stuff.
Extracting oxygen
All right.
and carbon
so how was I supposed to see that on the map?
Life in space and converting it to breathable oxygen, suitable for prolonged use by organic life.
Yeah, there's no map indicator that this is where I'm supposed to go.
Completed their missions in service of the decades long program.
Right side up.
Crew of 6 has commenced basic training.
Now,
North Star 4 is being constructed and assembled at Hardiman Launch Facility.
Hold F.
In advance of its 29 September 2035 mission active date. Hardiman Aerospace, mankind above all else.
Now it's bright. My balls. Interesting game so far. I mean, I don't really feel like I have much to comment at this point. There's no substance yet.
Survivor detected.
That's never a good sign.
Survivor detected.
Do I need to move or?
Survivor located. Initializing
there we go.
EDA HUD display.
What happened? Something system failure. Oh no! What the hell hit that thing? Well, don't just... I was gonna say, don't unwrap that. That seems to be keeping you... Oh, crap! I'm assuming this is a lady I'm playing as. She needs to stop panicking. She's making it worse.
EVA suit critically damaged.
Awesome.
Oxygen leak detected.
Oh.
Emergency life support system online. Manual oxygen refill required.
Well, I knew that you played somebody who ended up detached. I didn't realize you were also damaged. That sucks. Oh, I missed it. Ow. Hey, I got it. I feel like that was not very efficient, what I just did, though. I mean, I don't seem to be losing oxygen at a ridiculous rate. Ow. Does that actually hurt me? I don't see any life systems anywhere. Or did I lost oxygen when I bumped. Is that what happens? All right, so we're gonna hit this wall here in a second. Let's see what happens. No? Wasn't hard enough, apparently. Or is I think the ship's moving. It's not me. All right, what now? Can I ping? There's a locked door. The hole I came out of. Or is that the hole I came out of? That's the hole I came out of. So what's over here? Oh, the green. Go to green. It's one of those games. Ow! That does take away oxygen.
Initializing Hardiman aerospace identification sequence.
What we got? Oh.
Data transfer in progress. Identification verified. Oshima, Alex. Commander, Hardiman Aerospace North Star 4. Vital signs, stable.
That's good. I got it! Ha-ha! So is there anywhere that's actually sealed on this place? Do a tiny little boost. The game looks amazing.
Propulsion system damaged. Oxygen repurposed as shared life support and propulsion resource.
Oh!
Continual propulsion use incrementally depletes EVA oxygen reserves.
Hey, we grabbed on. Okay. I was like, do I have to waste energy slowing down, or can she brace slightly when we get close? That sucks. What hit this thing in order to do this level of damage? No, come back. How come you can't save these things? Why am I I'm looping it. No, pick it up. And we got one. That sucks. This place is just... Ow. Yeah, impacts.
Hardiman Aerospace North Star 4, this is Mission Control. Do you copy? Catastrophe signal received. Unable to determine current location or crew status. Please advise.
Ow! I might end up dead before I get there. So you are running out of oxygen, and your solution is to breathe as rapidly as you can. Well, that filled me completely up. Okay. Oops. So don't bump into things. It makes you lose oxygen quicker. All right, and then the other things are just modules I need to activate on the suit, on the left-hand side there. I have scan. I need capacity, thrust, boost, integrity.
Aerospace North Star 4. Catastrophic event detected.
Frick.
Origin point. Terminated.
What origin point? I will say this, the story is not exactly explaining a lot of it, but I don't know, I've never been a big fan of the whole we're not going to tell you what's going on, just figure it out as you go sort of thing. Oh shit! When you are outside of the facility, you drain at a much quicker rate. I'm going to need to burn some oxygen to get going in the right direction, though. Because I'm drifting. I'm adrift and drifting. It's an interesting little game. Yes, I'm right here. How do I talk to you? Ha-ha! So for a second or so while you're refilling, it seems like the canisters don't drain. I don't know how true that is, but that's what it looks like. Oh, this should be a nice clean grab. Yep. I think I'm right. I don't think it drains at the same rate when you're doing that. There we are. Now the drain's reduced. Well, this place seems quasi-functional.
Mission date, 8th July, 2037. Hardiman Aerospace, North Star 4. No remaining right. Survivors.
I'm it. Audio terminal. Can I do anything with that? Oh, card. Or SSD. What did that? I didn't bump into that. Ha ha! Ow. Wow, that's like an old school terminal. Developers, you missed an opportunity there. It's fully expected something there. This game is so good, actually. Just overall feel. It feels very immersive. I've seen that on the page more than a few people said, hey, VR glasses, highly recommended. I can see why. This feels immersive already, but VR would add just another layer to that. Alright, so does this do anything? No. Sync fail. You suck. So, this one? No, that's exit. Is that the one I came in? Ow. Or is that the one I came in? Let's go here. Screw it. Got to pick one of them, damn it. That's the one I came in. Damn it. Stop sucking me to the exit. I'm gonna turn around nice and slow like. Yeah, because the terminal's on the left. I remember that. That's the one I wanted. I burnt way too much oxygen with that move. Ah, shit. Yep, this is what I wanted. Aha! Ooh, oxygen. Gimme, 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 gimme. Haha! Just had to kind of nudge my way over to it. So is this HUD gonna flash the whole time? Because I'm not gonna lie, that might get a little annoying. Ow! My face! Oh, water drops. The detail's pretty badass in this game, I'm not gonna lie. It's the little shit like that that makes you feel you're doing it. Okay.
Warning. External EVA visor critically damaged. EVA repair required.
Okay. How?
Alright. For EVA repair station located.
Oh, just smacked it away. Ah, no! No, 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 no. Is that what I needed? What is this? I pushed the one button. Oh, it's somebody's room. Is this what I need for the repair? I see boots. What's that? Can I pick up that? HR violation. HR can bite me. Tell you what, HR can come up here. Oh, there we go. And do something about me violating this guy's space. So is this just text? Sure. That doesn't help me with my whole oxygen issue or my broken shit issue. That's what I was truly looking for. The problem is you can't instill a sense of urgency in a player and then expect them to want to slow down and read a book. So can I violate this person's space too? You're a space violator. You're violating their space in a lot of ways. Nope. Alright, what else we got? Hey, repair station! So wait a minute, is this repair station designed to be repaired while I'm in it? That seems like a bad idea. Oh, nice.
Hand for EVA repair sequence complete. Vital signs stable.
Okay. I can dig this. Oh, it looks clear, too. Like it should. Well, they didn't have smudges on the glass or something. That was literally one of my number one pet peeves with Elite, is the glass of your ship looks like butt. Right, I'm gonna leave that, actually. It's a flower. Hello, flower. I could see where VR would come in handy for this, because it is slow as shit turning. Oh, is this my room? Yeah. Pardon me, I'm going to take a moment in the middle of potentially dying because I'm floating in space to check my email. Why not? It's what I'd do. If they want me to do that, they'd have to give me a safe environment to do it from. So can I actually read this if I get close enough? Nope, I'm just going to slap the shit out of it. Well, screw you, card.
Hand for personal data device. See, version 4.7 acquired.
This is okay. I can move forward in the story while I listen to this crap.
Location coordinates unknown.
Even though she seems to have the same idea I do of going through that extra crap. I'm floating in space and could die. I don't care about a lot of the other crap that's going on yet. Give me a reason. This feels like a very slow game to me.
Systems repair required for emergency escape vehicle launch.
There's an emergency escape vehicle? Oh, I wonder if that's my goal. All right, the heads-up display is damn near useless for what I should be doing. All right, so looking at this and looking at the display, which, by the way, is a light color against a light color, does it want me to go this way? Is that it? Is that the one I need? Maybe yes, no. I can't tell until I get too close. And the problem is, when you're burning resources to move from place to place, don't get me wrong, I'm having a lot of fun with the game. It's an interesting experience. I mean, this is closer to a walking simulator more than anything, to be honest. The oxygen, though, that does definitely put something looming just barely overhead at all times. But there's a couple of interface things they need to resolve, like that. I don't know whether or not that would be a keyboard I'd use until I'm like point blank. I mean, alternatively, I could scan, I guess, but scan's not showing to use the computer. I mean, it shows me I got some resources over there. So it's just kind of pick a path and go for it. All right. So for the overall style and type that we're dealing with in regards to the UI, I am going to go ahead and give it 1 point. We are giving it a point for the overall design issues because it's just not quite telling you what's going on. And in a game like this, that's kind of very important. Just saying. Because if my every move drains resource, I need to make sure I'm not wasting resource going from point A to point B. See? Like, this was okay. But I'm wondering, is this the direction I came from earlier? I don't know.
Personal log. Systems specialist.
Oh, personal log.
Andrew, 17, April, 2037.
Finally going home.
Ah.
Doesn't even seem real. 22 months since mission start. 10 longer than I signed up for in the first place.
Yay.
I promised Lucy I was going to be there for her. I promised myself I wouldn't leave her like this again.
Oh no, it's a gut-wrenching story from a dead man.
Selfish paycheck job while real life passes me by down below.
Alright, a couple of investigative points. Oxygen
stuff. Alex really came through for me on this. I owe her one. Can't wait to get off this goddamn station.
He doesn't seem happy. Okay, so that was the guy I was just listening to. Gotta check his email now. Early beta. Blah, blah, blah. More crap. I don't care. I mean, again, I'm sure that it's a compelling world thing that they've built here. But I'm not really feeling that. The best way to explain how I'm feeling about this is the equivalent of having a horror game where you have to worry about the monster coming and eating you at any second, and then be like, stop here, check your email, just in case. Nobody's going to do that in a horror game. You notice my suit's gotten slowly more beat up the more I float around, though? I could have swore it told me there was an investigation point here. Make sure I'm not crazy. Oh, that's dumb. It showed the computer in the inside. Back to free floating. Looking for random crap. So what, this whole area is a lost cause or what? Let me try reinvestigating that damn computer since it will not go away on my screen. There we are. That's what I looked at before. Yeah, the 1 point for user interface is definitely deserved, that's for sure. What? Oh! Oh! Oh. Oh. They weren't kidding when they said alternate route. Oh, that's not good. Ow. Leak at hazardous levels. Uh-oh, I see you. Gotcha. Is that a door over there? Where do I get back in? Is it over there? No, that's the way I came out. Oh crap. Don't hit that. Okay. We're good. Where am I supposed to be going? Damn you, game, tell me. Aha, gotcha.
North Star 4, this is Mission Control. Unable to determine current location or crew status. Please advise. Over.
Go look for us? How far am I going to make with this, and where am I supposed to be going? I mean, I've got kind of like a weird arrow marker. But I don't know if that's it. Am I supposed to be going to that? Or am I supposed to be going to this? I'm going to burn a little oxygen, even though that's a terrible idea. Did I come here already? Hang on. Let's look. Again, VR would come in handy for this, being able to look around. Maybe? I don't know. The problem is, they have a 2D radar in three-dimensional space. That hardly ever works out well for games. And my mask is all back to broken again. Alright, well, we're gonna try to go in here, because it just didn't really tell me where I should be going. I can't tell. Is this different? I think it is.
Hand 4 Spirit is mainframe damaged and offline.
There we are.
Manual repair required.
Yay, solid state. Okay. How do I manually repair it? Yeah, fun game so far. User interface is garbage. As far as telling you what to do. That's a little harsh. It's not that it's garbage itself. It's that it doesn't give you enough information to really make a valid determination as to what you should be doing. Like, for all I know, I've already gone here, but I can't quite tell. Sure, we're going there. You know, I can't tell how far that is. This may be a terrible idea. This may be the last you see of me. Alright, I'm not actually putting any thrust out. I just kind of give it one big oomph. And we're going to see if we can coast the rest of the way. It's a catch-22 with this game. I know where they're going, as far as idea. But I can take both hands off and just kind of drift. I mean, it looks amazing. You know, the bloom can go straight to hell. I hate bloom. Anyone that knows me knows I hate bloom.
Star 4, survivor identified. Commander Alex Oshima. Verify your status, Commander. Standing by.
How? How do I verify my status? Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this as far as the episode. We're gonna keep floating towards this while I do it, though. It only got one point. It's because the user interface doesn't really explain that much. It's kind of just figure it out. And I hate their compass. Absolutely hate that compass. I'd be better off without it, I think, because right now it gives me hope I should be going in a certain direction. The game itself is not going to be action-packed, nor is it particularly chilling. Like, yeah, I know I'm running out of oxygen, but it's not really compelling about that. Probably because of how much wandering it is and how much trying to figure out what's going on it is. I don't know. Maybe it's just me, but I've never really had a moment where I was like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna die. Did I loop all the way back to where I started? And that's the other thing. So many of the environments are identical. Again, not bad. Just not compelling. I have no idea what it's doing now. It keeps trying to make me look at the ground. Well, this is different. Sort of. Ow. Bump, something lost a bunch of oxygen. Random broken pieces. It's over here. More random broken pieces. It's not giving me any goal. I mean, if there is a goal, I haven't been able to directly locate it. I mean, there's arrows on the mini-map, but they just kind of are looping themselves now whenever I go to pivot. What does that mean? But yeah, here we sit and sit. It technically probably should get a second point for some of the other issues in regards to explanation of the interface and whatnot. The initial point was just for how the user interface looks. As far as not telling you what's going on, it's very lacking in the explanation department. I am going to go ahead and give it a second point for the compass. Specifically, I'm splitting that off as something separate because it's a separate issue in itself. That's not just not telling you where you need to go. That's not even explaining where you are in relation to anything. And I think that that is a pretty big deal. That's something that you need in order to understand what you should be doing in the game. But, I mean, overall, 2 points. 2 points is pretty solid for a game like this. I expected more, to be perfectly frank. At a glance, I expected it to have more issues. But, I mean, it's not been terrible. Is it an amazingly compelling game that I feel driven to keep doing stuff in? Not really. It's a variation of a walking simulator. And not exactly overly compelling at that. It's not a bad game. I wouldn't say it's terrible. But anyway, I would like to get some feedback from the people watching this. What do you think of this game? Looking at it, do you think this is amazing or do you think it's kind of meh? It's going for $20 US on Steam. Do you feel it's a $20 game? I don't know yet. But as always, I am the Brain Damage Gamer. I would like to thank everybody for watching. Feel free to, like I said, leave me that feedback. Put it in the comment section down below. Throw me a tweet on Twitter. I have a Facebook page as well. Leave me that information on social media in some way or another. What do you think of this game? If you did like the video, feel free to hit like. And as always, I'm the Brain Damage Gamer. Game on.